So, our question number five is again very, very important question for, especially for higher classes, to be fair. Okay, ninth class, 10th class, you will find these questions everywhere. Now, the question arises, first of all, what is so special in this? P square plus 6p plus 8. And what is the difference between this question and this question? This should come to your mind. I don't know whether it is coming to your mind or not. A square plus 8a plus 16. Isn't it both questions look similar? Let me
Yes,
just
sir.
write it for you. A square plus 8a plus 16. A square plus 8a plus 16. And another question is P square plus 6p plus 8. According to me, in the first look, both questions are same. Yes, no. Sana.
Yes.
Then why this question is, I would say, 3-star important, and this question is only 1-star important. Let me just share my experience. Actually, both the questions are in the form a square plus 2ab plus b square. Okay. Whereas one is in this form, other is not in this form. Just observe a square plus 2ab plus b square. A square is a square. 16 can be written as 4. So a 4. 4 into 2, 8. 8 into a. So you get this form. Yes, no?
Yes,
Yes.
sir.
Whereas here, a square plus 2ab plus b square is not possible. What we will write. Actually, what you were doing over here was square root of 16, which is 4, isn't it? Square root of 8 is not that easily possible. Understood this thing? That's why it is not in this form. Do you understand, Aaron?
Yes, I understand.
Sana, what about you?
Yes, I understand.
So, this question is solvable using this identity a plus b whole square, whereas answer would be a plus 4 whole square, a plus 4, a plus 4. But when these identities are not possible in this quadratic equation, then we use middle term splitting. Remember, I have shared another video regarding this already, how to do this thing. So we use middle term splitting. So how to do that thing? Let me just share it with you once again so that you revise your answer. Step number one, first term and last term we multiply. I'm erasing the rest of the part. If you want to write, you can write your steps. Step number one, you multiply first and the last term. You get 8, only constant part. Okay. Step number two, find all the factors of the number. 1 into 8, 2 into 4, 3 is not possible, 4 is already done. You understand? I'm finding simple factors, 1 and 8, 2 and 4. Now we will see middle term 6, either by adding or by subtracting. 8 plus 1 is not equal to 6. 8 minus 1 is not equal to 6. Understood? So 8 minus 1 is not a good option. So 8 and 1 is not a good option. 2 and 4. 4 minus 2 is not equal to 6. But 4 plus 2 is equal to 6. Understood?
Yes, sir.
So we will take 4 and 2. But there are two possibilities for addition. One is minus minus plus, one is plus plus plus. Minus 2 minus 4 will give you minus 6. Plus 2 plus 4 will give you plus 6. Do I need plus 6 or minus 6? What do I need?
So you need plus 6.
Plus 6. So this thing is not allowed. So we will take this thing. So p square plus 2p plus 4p plus 8. You can write 4p first, 2p later on. It's absolutely fine. Now this question becomes very similar to the first exercise question. Very similar, or I would say same. In the first exercise, there were four numbers. These questions.
Yes, sir.
Whenever there are four numbers, four terms, we take first two common, last two common. Remember? So we will follow that procedure. So from the first two, P is common. So from the first term, P is left, plus, and 2 is left. When I'm taking common, that means I'm dividing them. P square divided by P will give me P. 2P divided by P will give me 2. From these two, 4 is common. 4P divided by 4P plus 8 divided by 4, 2. These two brackets should be same. Hence, my answer is P plus 2, which is these two terms, and P plus 4 are the factors. Any doubt? Quickly copy this thing, and there is a need of improvement in your homework. Do the last two parts right now and send them to me right now. So second part dekh lete hain jaldi se. Yahan pe pehla aur aakhri term ka jo multiply karke aaya wo 21 aaya. 21 ke factors 1 into 21, 2 se hoga nahi. 3 into 7, 4 se nahi hoga, 5 se nahi hoga, 6 se nahi hoga, 7. So these two are the factors. 7 plus 3, 10 hota hai, but yahan pe kya chahiye? Minus 10 chahiye. Okay, so minus 3, minus 7. I'm telling you the process jo mere dimag mein chal raha hai. So 7q or 3q. Very good, minus ka. To pehle do mein se q common, q minus 7. Phir yahan pe minus 3 common. Very good. So, agar common le rahe, maine jaise ki bataya, we have to divide. So, minus 3q divided by minus 3. So, you get q. That's why positive q. Aur yahan pe kya 21? 21 divided by minus 3, you get minus 7. That's why it is minus 7. So, ye bahut hi basic rule hota hai. Jab bhi aap negative number common le rahe ho, to ये प्रोसीजर फॉलो करोगे तो कभी भी गलती नहीं होगी. सो q minus 7 सेम था और q minus 3 फैक्टर्स. जस्ट राइट वन स्टेटमेंट्स है ना, आर द फैक्टर्स. हम फैक्टराइजेशन कर रहे हैं ना.
ओके
okay. पता तो चले दिमाग को कर क्या रहे हैं. हम एम ही करे जा रहे हैं बस. सर ने बोला विल्टर्स फिटिंग कर दो, कर दो. इजंट इट फैक्टर्स का मतलब हो गया आने वाले चैप्टर्स में, आने वाले क्लासेस में हम इनका डिवाइड भी करेंगे. व्हेन यू डिवाइड दीज टू नंबर्स यू विल गेट दिस एज क्वेश्चन. When you divide these two numbers, you will get this as quotient. Do you understand? इसका मतलब क्या है? इन दोनों को multiply करके you are getting this. It is just like 2 into 5 is 10. जब मैं 10 को 5 से divide करूँगा तो 2 आएगा ना? Yes? You understand this thing? उसी तरीके से इसको और इसको divide करेंगे तो ये आएगा answer. तो इसलिए बोल रहा हूँ statement लिखा करो. These are the factors. Okay, quickly last question भी देख लेते हैं. 1 and 16. यहाँ पे क्या? -16. Make sure. 1 into -16 is -16. So 16 के अगर मैं factors देखूँ, तो 1 into 16, 2 into 8, 3 से होगा नहीं, 4 into 4, तो हो गया खत्म. तो मुझे क्या चाहिए? 6 चाहिए. तो 8 and 2 से आएगा 6. ओके, 8 and 2 से 6 आएगा माइनस करके. तो मुझे क्या चाहिए? पॉजिटिव 6 चाहिए. पॉजिटिव 6 कैसे आएगा? 8 minus 2. सो यू हैव टेकन -2 फर्स्ट, वो भी ठीक है. अगर 8 minus 2 लेते तो भी ठीक आता आंसर. आंसर सेम आएगा. P(P-2) + 8(P-2). वेरी गुड आर द फैक्टर्स. ठीक है, यहाँ पर ये हमने क्वेश्चंस कर लिए, बट ये क्वेश्चंस इम्पोर्टेंट अच्छे नहीं है इतने, मैं आपको बता दूँ. क्योंकि सबसे बुरी बात क्या है, यहाँ पे सब में फैक्ट, यहाँ पे क्या है? 1. डू यू ऑब्जर्व दिस थिंग? बट क्या जरूरी है हमेशा 1 आएगा? यस एरन, डू यू थिंक?
नो
सर. 1 विल कम?
नो.
सो देयर आर सम क्वेश्चंस एंड एग्जांपल्स. क्विकली ये वाला क्वेश्चन करो. 3m² + 9m + 6. 3m² + 9m + 6. Follow this method and do this question right now. 3m² + 9m + 6. Okay? And iske baad hai. एनसीईआरटी में तो और कोई क्वेश्चन नहीं है. ये क्वेश्चन है बट इसमें भी 1 ही है. बट यू कैन प्रैक्टिस. z² - 4z - 12. ओके, इसके बाद ये भी सेम क्वेश्चन देख रहे हो. बट देयर इज ओनली 1 क्वेश्चन इन एनसीईआरटी जहां पर पहला नंबर ए जो है वो 1 के अलावा कुछ और है. तो दीज टू क्वेश्चन अभी जल्दी से करो. दिस विल गिव यू एन आइडिया वेदर यू हैव अंडरस्टूड द कॉन्सेप्ट और नॉट. सो लेट अस डिस्कस दिस वन. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल 3m² + 9m + 6. आई डोंट नो वेदर यू आर डूइंग द रफ वर्क और नॉट. फॉर मी रफ वर्क इज इंपॉर्टेंट. 3 into 6 is 18. Okay, 18 ka ho gaya 1 into 18, 2 into 9. Right now ye aapko important nahi lag raha hoga method, but zaruri nahi hai na ki sirf hamesha whole number hai. 9th class mein yahan pe root lag jayega. What I'm trying to say, jo method bata raha hu usko follow karo. 3 into 6, 4 के टेबल में जाएगा नहीं, 5 के टेबल में जाएगा नहीं, 6 हो गया. ठीक है, तो वी नीड 9 ओवर हियर. 9 कैसे आएगा? 3 प्लस 6. सो 6 प्लस 3 आपने कर दिया. वेरी गुड. 6 प्लस 3 9m और 6 into 3 18. तो फर्स्ट टू में से कॉमन आ गया 3m. तो यहाँ पर m बचा, यहाँ पर 2 बचा. तो यहाँ पर 3 कॉमन आया, m और 2. वेरी गुड, 3m + 3. अभी यहाँ पे और एक चीज बची है, मैं आपको दिखाता हूँ. अगर आप ध्यान से देखते इस क्वेश्चन को, तो पहले से ही कुछ कॉमन आ रहा था, है ना? जिसमें 3 में से आपको 2.5 ही मिलेगी, फुल नहीं मिलेंगे. I'll tell you why. तो 3 कॉमन आ रहा था. क्वेश्चन था एक्चुअली m² + 9m + 2, नॉट 9m, 3m. कॉमन आ गया ना. ओके तो आप बोलोगे सर अब इसको सॉल्व करूं, नहीं, यू कैन टेक कॉमन थ्री फ्रॉम हेयर ऑल्सो, थ्री कॉमन ले लोगे तो क्या आएगा, एम प्लस टू एम प्लस वन. डिड यू अंडरस्टैंड दिस थिंग? इफ यू सॉल्व दिस थिंग यू विल गेट द सेम रिजल्ट, एम प्लस टू एम प्लस वन. एनी डाउट?
I didn't understand where we got 18 from.
18? 3 into 6?
Yeah. Oh, okay.
First, and I wrote the steps, na? You watch the video yeah. again if you have not yeah. written the yeah. steps. Sana, is this thing clear? How I got this thing?
Yes, clear.
Very good. There are both the ways are correct. Your way is absolutely correct, but if something is common, you have to take. Otherwise, if you look at the question carefully, there was three common. So take three common in the beginning and then do the Milton split. Whatever. Let me just move to the next part. So we get 12, 1 into 12, 12. 1 into 12, 2 into 6, 3 into 4. So you want minus 4, which you will get from here, which will be 2 minus 6. So your answer is incorrect. Understood? You need 2 minus 6, then only you will get minus 4. What you are doing, minus 2 plus 6. Okay.
Okay.
But why your answer is coming correct? Let me just see. Z is minus 2. And you got 6, 6 minus Z minus 2. इस बार तो तुक्का लग गया बट हर बार नहीं लगेगा. ओके लेट मी जस्ट डू इट हियर. जेड स्क्वायर माइनस फोर जेड माइनस ट्वेल्व. जेड स्क्वायर टू माइनस सिक्स जेड माइनस ट्वेल्व. जेड जेड माइनस जेड प्लस टू minus 6, z plus 2, z plus 2, and z minus 6 is the answer. So can you see? Your answer is incorrect. Okay.
Okay. So I got z plus 2 and z minus 6 is my answer.
Very good. Quickly do the correction and revise these questions from your workbook.